care of us, son, don't worry. Now Jacob loved more Joseph more than any of his other sons, because Joseph had been born to him in old age.
Jacob gave his son a beautifully decorated coat because he loved him so much.
His brothers became very jealous and hated him. They treated him badly and would not speak kindly to him.
You've got to be kidding. Do you really think that you're going to rule over us?
You're so annoying. We'll never bow down to you.
No way. We don't even like you.
Poor Joseph. My brothers hated him anymore.
But I didn't stop him. He had a dream. It was time he was over.
Joseph really did this time. His brothers became even more jealous and spiteful, but his father continued to think about what all these things could mean. Your brothers are going to shepherd your beautiful flock. I want you to go and find them. When Joseph arrived in Shechem, a man told him that his brothers had moved on to Dothan, so Joseph went to find them.
His brothers recognized him from a distance and began to plot against him.
Here comes that dreamer boy. Let's get him.
Let's kill him and throw him into a pit and tell father that wild animals attacked him.
Then we'll see about those stupid dreams of his.
No, we shouldn't take his life. Let's not shed any blood. Instead, let's shove him in the pit, but make sure we don't hurt him.
Joseph came up to his brothers, they grabbed him and tore off the coat on him.
Then they threw him into the pit and went off to eat.
Just about that time, a caravan of Ishmaelites came up the road. Hey, you guys, what good will it do if we kill our brother and then try to cover up? Let's sell him to the Ishmaelites and not lay a hand on him, after all, he is our brother.
Okay, let's sell him and keep the money for ourselves.
I just came back and saw that Joseph was not in the pit. What am I supposed to do now? How can I tell father? So the brothers devised a plan to kill a goat and smear the blood on Joseph's coat and take it to their father.
Look, father, we found this coat. It looks like the one you gave Joseph.
Hold on, that's not his coat. The poor animal must have an orphan. So Jacob left for his son Joseph.
Meanwhile, the Ishmaelites took Joseph to Egypt and sold him to Potiphar, one of Pharaoh's officials.
Joseph served Potiphar and lived in his house. The Lord was with Joseph, and he prospered. When Potiphar saw the Lord was with Joseph, he put him in charge of his entire household. The Lord blessed everything Potiphar had because of Joseph.
Joseph was a handsome man in Potiphar's life.
Joseph, come to my house and stay with me.
I can't do that. My master has put me in charge of his whole household and trusted me with everything. Or his wife, how can I do such an evil thing against my master God?
This went on day after day, and Joseph continued to refuse her requests.
One day, all the servants were gone.
Potiphar's wife grabbed Joseph's garment and asked him to go to her home again.
This time, Joseph ran out of the house but left his garment in her hand.
Potiphar's wife was humiliated and furious.
She called for her servants and lied about what happened.
Look at this. The Hebrews just tried to happened. When I screamed for help, he ran off running and left his sword behind. I'm going to tell my husband when he gets home.
Potiphar was furious when he heard the news. He had Joseph put in prison.
But the Lord was with Joseph, and he found favor in the prisoner's eyes.
So Joseph was put in charge of all the prisoners, and the prison keeper left him alone.
The Lord blessed everything Joseph did in the prison.
Thank you for this day. Thank you for our school. I pray for our military leaders.